most machine learning models, you give them a cost function that they should minimize. For example, they should make very few mistakes on the training set. In adversarial machine learning, there's now two players at two costs. So maybe you have one machine learning model that's trying to accurately recognize spam messages, and there's also a spammer who's trying to fool your spam detector into letting the spam messages get through.
Now, why would you need an adversarial network versus just having a pool of data somewhere that you could use?
Yeah, so sometimes there's a real-world adversary, like someone who actually wants to fool our system into making a wrong prediction, somebody who can actually make money by causing us to make a mistake. For example, in search engines, you've heard of search engine optimization, where people earn money by figuring out how to get sites ranked higher. You could imagine that someone would want to fool the Google search ranking algorithm into ranking a site higher than they should. That's the kind of thing that becomes adversarial machine learning, when there's actually someone who has an incentive to do something that isn't in your training set. Other times, we actually make up imaginary conflicts because they give the model an opportunity to practice and do something useful. For example, generative adversarial networks learn to produce realistic images via an imaginary competition between an image generator and an image discriminator, where the generator tries to make realistic images, the discriminator gets points for detecting fake images and blocking them.